Following terrible election losses, the Republicans had a choice to make. Could they actually support some policies that the majority of Americans support and would thus vote for Republicans for? That's too difficult. They found something else they can do, and that is try to stop as many people from voting as possible. And so, although there is no evidence of systemic fraud in the recent elections, lawmakers in 43 states are debating about 200 bills that would limit ballot access, according to the Brennan Center for Justice, a public policy group. Now, we've talked about this multiple times over the past couple of weeks. We've also given you updates on a couple of the particular bills that were most likely to pass and were the most egregious. And now, regrettably, we have to give you the update on a couple because they have actually passed. And so let's take a look at Iowa, where Governor Kim Reynolds on Monday signed into law a Republican-backed bill that makes it harder to vote early, potentially eroding a key aspect of Democratic campaigns. Could have been Republican campaigns too, but they decided to turn against early voting for some reason rather than just getting Republicans to vote early too. Anyway, Republicans in the House and Senate quickly approved the voting changes over the opposition of all Democratic legislators. Republicans said the new rules were needed to guard against voting fraud, though they noted Iowa has no history of election irregularities and that November's election saw record turnout with no hint of problems in the state. The law shortens the early voting period to 20 days from the current 29, just 3 years after Republicans reduced the period from 40 days, so it's now half of what it was. It also requires most mail ballots to be received by election day rather than counting votes postmarked by election day that arrive by noon of the Monday following the election. Voting sites will close at 8 rather than 9 because, as everyone knows, voting fraud happens between 8 and 9. So they thankfully cut that off. That makes sense. And county election officials are banned from sending out absentee ballot request forms unless requested. They also do some stuff to satellite voting sites and a lot of other things, Quay. But basically, they are attempting to cut back on as many of the areas where more voting has been generated in recent elections.
Yeah, it's, I don't know. I mean, it's just wild anymore. And it, again, it's that type of thing that seems pretty clear on the face of itself what's going on. And yet, saying the quiet piece out loud that nobody really would care to stop it. So I really don't know what to say about that. I mean, it's horrible. I really think that we should be pushing for a national holiday, election holiday, at least once every 2 years kind of a thing, if not every year. And that's not necessarily going to stop these states from, you know, from doing what they're doing. But I think it puts a little more pressure that this is kind of a national culture, or this is, you know, the culture of a country that, hey, you know, we're off on election day so that people have the ability to vote.
I think it's a great idea. Yeah, it wouldn't help with quite a few of these state level things, but it would at least give people a fighting chance on election day, especially those who are potentially struggling with multiple jobs, with long hours and can't get a way to actually vote. It would certainly help with that. And it is possible that setting up some sort of democracy day, which I've been pushing for years, could generate a conversation nationally, right, about the state of American democracy, who is defending it and who is assaulting it. And it would be just one part of what would be necessary. But I think it could help. I think that it's long past due that we've had that conversation. And the thing about Iowa is, like, I get that they're trying to do this stuff in Georgia, and we're gonna talk about Georgia in a little bit. In Iowa, Trump won by 9 points. 9 points. Like, they were already gonna win. I mean, I know years past in Iowa it was close, right, or whatever. Like, it seems almost unnecessary in Iowa to do this. Like, in Georgia, sure, you lost by just a little bit, so you wanna screw those people over to win. It's not even determining the winner in Iowa. It's almost like, well, if other places are doing it, we wanna get in on the fun. Sure. We wanna stop some votes.
Flex. It's a bit of a flex, right? You know, just like, hey, look how cool we've got our voters suppressed.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.